So our first presentation today is by Juha Kaija, who's a senior specialist at GTK. And he's going to be talking to us about the GTK's EU projects, the summary, and some practical lessons. Please. Yes.
Thank you, David. And tere hommikust, hyvää huomenta. Good morning, everybody. And thank you, Cyril, for really excellent dinner yesterday. It was really fun there. So I'm Juha Kaija, and I have been working at GTK since more or less permanently since 1995, when GTK joined EU. And we started our very first EU project called Palmottu, analog project. And at that time, I was working at the Nuclear Waste Disposal Research Unit. But senior specialist, my specialization is project management. I mean, building consortiums, writing proposals, leading the projects, and ending those, hopefully successfully. But my background is in hydrogeology. So the content of my presentation, I will tell a little bit about the main projects in the minerals sector, which GTK has had during the years. I mean, Framework 7, Horizon 2020, and Horizon Europe projects. Then I will also talk a little bit about the EGT Twin project, which is at the moment under evaluation in the Commission. And that was a joint effort of EGT, GTK, and Geological Survey of Denmark and Greenland, British Geological Survey, and Oulu University. And I was hoping, or I was talking to Shirley and others, that I hope that we will get a positive evaluation results while we are here, because that would be a perfect ending for this conference. Then I will show some examples of GTK's cooperation network and a summary of Mireo and next project. And while I was here, I'm talking with different people, and we heard also yesterday that social license to operate is important issue also in Estonia, so I will concentrate on those issues. This is the GTK's mineral sector portfolio since 2009. In this slide you have 16 projects. In 13 years, the total budget of this project was 81 million euros from European Union. And GTK's share was about 8 million euros from EU. And Promine was actually, yes, Promine was the first really big project, 17.2 million euros in total. And it was about the nanoparticle products from new mineral resources in Europe. And then we had next new exploration technologies projects, almost 7 million euros. And Promine was Framework 7 program goal. And now we have this. On the bottom, there is ACE, Exploration Information System, that is actually starting 1st of May this year. And those you, which have been emphasized, like circled, Promine, Minerals for EU, Orama, Mireo, Next, and ACE, they were coordinated by GTK. And I was personally involved in Promine, Minerals for EU, Mireo, Next, actually, and also in ACE as a project manager. And I have emphasized this twinning, ENERAC. That was excellency network building for comprehensive research and assessment of geofluids. That was a twinning project, which was actually one of the models for this EGT twin proposal. But we had also others there. Then maybe Pekka recognized the photo there. That was taken because the Promine got the first prize of the amongst the all funded technological projects of the Framework 7 program. And we had this in Athens 2013. But what I wanted to say about this picture is that European Union, they established this raw materials initiative in 2008. And since then, there has been a lot of calls related to minerals sector. But Promine was actually one of the first projects funded, I don't know, maybe in 10 years, because before 2009, there was hardly any minerals related project funded. And what else? Well, you can see the framework 7. We had a pro mine minerals for EU, which were coordinated by GTK, and then Eurare, we were partners in that project. That was led by National Technical University of Athens. And then after 2013, the Horizon 2020 goals were announced. So we were really successful in getting those proposals funded. And but I must say that personally, it was when you are looking at, for example, 2019 and 2020, I was coordinating or managing Agria's evaluation management of arsenic contamination in agricultural soils and water, then next, Mireo, and Minex target. So that was a little bit too much work. But of course, we always have at GTK, we have a project manager and scientific coordinator who are dealing with, we are two persons who are, we know what is happening in the process. We both know if something happens, if some of us is on holidays or things like that. And then the next target, which is still ongoing, it's about the enhanced use of heavy mineral chemistry in exploration targeting. That is the only example I saw in this slide of the European Innovation and Technology Raw Matters project. But at the moment we have, GTK is involved in 14 of those projects. So these are really important for GTK. Then these are the four, there are at least two more Horizon Europe new proposals which are under evaluation. And there we have this EGT twin, enhancing research capacity at the Geological Survey of Estonia to accelerate the country's transition to green energy. And this is, I really hope that it will get funded, because that would be a very good opportunity for continue our cooperation. And Kimo said yesterday that this EGT twin would be like an umbrella so that we could start something new, for example, in relation to geoenergy research. And this is the, in nutshell, the EGT twin. We submitted that in January this year, and it was really excellent cooperation between Eesti Geologiateenistus, Geologian tutkimuskeskus, and PGS, Geological Survey of Denmark and Greenland, and University of Oulu. And the main objective is to strengthen the research and scientific excellence capacity at EGT. It will be based like on exchange of knowledge from PGS, GTK, Geus, and Oulu. And it's concentrated on the fields of geological, geochemical, and geophysical surveying techniques, 3D modeling, digital capture and management, critical raw materials exploration. Geothermal is one of the most important part of that, and also social license to explore and social license to operate, and of course the project management. So if we get this funded, you will see me a lot more. And this is an example of GTK's cooperation network. And there's a link on the bottom. It's a Cooris Europe open data portal. And you can find all the funded projects in that database. And this is just, I don't know, how maybe there is 150 something collaboration between different partners in Europe. And this is only for 17. Horizon 2020 projects. And this can have a really vast network. Also individual researchers, of course, they have their own networks. And we use this networking also when we are planning the new projects and cooperation with other partners. And this is an example of what kind of organizations we have had as a partners in 25 projects. And of course, we are a research organization, so research organizations' cooperation is important for us. But also industry and technology-oriented SMEs are important partners. And this is there's like 17 countries listed, and Germany and Spain and France, they are, we have had most cooperation with these countries. I mean the partners or organizations from these countries. And it's a pity Estonia is not in this. We have had Estonian partners, for example, Tartu University, but I hope that it will gradually grow also. And this is a, well, top 10 of the partners. And BRGM, French Geological Survey, is, as Pekka also knows, it has been a really important partner for us during the decades. And then from Spain we have CSIC, that's like Technical Research Center of Spain. And they are also, they have been in 6 projects with us. And of this list, there are over half of these are geological surveys. And then to Mireo. Mireo was about the mining and metallurgy regions of the European Union. And the main objective was to actually to promote investment, innovation and growth in the mineral sector, as well as the regional cooperation. And the emphasis is in the regional cooperation and regions. And there is this small map, you can see that those mining regions were on board of Miro, and there are like 17 of those. I guess the Regional Council of Lapland actually lobbied this call to the European Union, and they started to building up the consortium. And if I remember right, there was some contacts to Estonia also, but nothing happened. And I jumped on board after the consortium had been already agreed. So there was no way to, no way to start to influence on the consortium structure. And why the regions are important? Because of course they are key actors enabling extractive industry through value chain policies, land use planning and regional development plans. And they also know their own playground, the problems and what kind of communities they have. And these mining and metallurgical regions, many times they recognize the extractive industries as important to their development. And they also know about the environmental problems and other downsides of the sector. And one of the main point that Mireo was starting was that we knew that, of course, we have mining and metallurgy regions in Europe, but there was not real cooperation between these regions. And we tried to make that a change on that thinking. And then also that the voice of mining and metallurgy regions, that was not heard in Brussels. And we tried to change that also. And these are the focus areas of the Miro. And I would say that the main point was to enhance cooperation between different regions and different organizations, and try to learn from each other, and try to give best practices. Because, for example, if in Portugal they have handled some issue really well, and in Finland we don't have that information, we are trying to freely share that information. And all these publications or reports of Miro, they are public, and they can be found from the Miro websites. And one important issue was to develop this kind of EU-level social license to operate guidelines and toolkit. And for the intention that it will raise the social awareness of mining and metallurgy at the regions. And we established, this was one of the main goals of the Mireo. It's a COMER, Council of Mining and Metallurgy Regions of Europe. And this is, it exists, but it has not yet started its operation. But in June we have in Brussels a meeting that we will actually try to launch it properly. And this is open for everyone. Also, organizations or universities, everybody is welcome to join. And also we would like to see also representatives of the regional authorities or ministries on board of this council. And this will be hosted by ERIN in Belgium. And ERIN is the European Regional Innovation and Research Network. And well, these are some lessons from Mirel. And we recognize that there are only few regions in the EU that define themselves as in a socio-economic and strategic way as a mining region. And excuse me. The small share of mining in most regions, it seems to be a secondary importance compared to downstream industry. And because of this, there is a different level of political support also. And many times there's a lack of raw materials awareness at the governmental level, but also at the regional level. And also, you know that geology is not teach at the primary schools or because I would like to see that somewhere in the teaching strategy there would be at least something about the region where you are living and what is under your feet, what kind of bedrock and things like that. So about the Mireo social license to operate toolbox. As I said, there is actually the link where you can download those reports. And there were like key results where we had 5 relationship building activities for different type of organizations or stakeholders. And there were 15 tools which are listed or described in these reports. And there is also this kind of social license to operate good practices and recent disputes. And there are 47 cases across the Europe. And it was actually Tony Eerola from GTK who made a huge work with this report. And Tony is our social license to operate key person at GTK. This is the toolbox. It's like these relations building activities from activity 1, familiarize, and then 2, introduce, reach out, establish, and strengthen. And there are tools for authorities, tools for communities, and tools for companies. So it's actually quite comprehensive report. And these are our partners, and here are email addresses. Kaisa Turunen was the scientific coordinator of this Mirel. Then next. Vesa Nykänen, the research professor on mineral exploration at GTK, was the scientific coordinator, and I was the manager of this. And this was also Horizon 2020. Oh, sorry. What happened? Horizon 2020 project, and we actually are in the middle of a final report in the European Union. It takes a lot of time. So the main objective of the next was to develop innovative and sensitive exploration concepts and technologies. And this felt like we had 5 pillars for this project. Technology related, so new and more sensitive exploration technologies and solutions. Then economy, economy related, exploration at the lowest possible cost. Then reduction of the exploration footprint and improving awareness of the society on exploration issues. And this I will not go into details, but there are some highlights here, what were our specific objectives. And I would say that a novel geophysical AM electromagnetic system for ore exploration was one of our main objectives. And then new advanced methods for data processing and data integration. Now here's the drone that was built by Radai, SME company from Finland. And of course we must have the logos of European Union and our project logo there. And we had a work package on technology, and we had different tasks there, like EM for drones, multi-source surface geochemistry, vector magnetic field, and satellite imaginary downloader. And it was about exploration targeting in guiding exploration to specific locations for bedrock drilling and to avoid the need of conventional use of heavy machinery assisted sampling, which would possibly be also socially more acceptable. And about this slide, well, this novel EM survey system, we actually got the European Commission Innovation Radar acknowledgement of this as a development that has the most business potential in this project. And it was done by actually three partners, Radai, Loop and Line from Finland and GTK. This Sim, I want to, I guess you will get all these presentations later, but this is, there is the, about this GISSOM and so, self-organizing maps, and you have a links there. You can check them if it's useful for you. And this is the social license to explore, and it was actually a new term developing in within this project. And we noticed that the main outcomes of this social license to explore work package was the important issues were that the earliest possible communication and interaction with the local community, these are really number one thing to do. And to know the local context is also a precondition for the SLE. And of course, the national legislation sets the framework for the SLE. But there's a good report on social license to explore, also public. I will send you the links. But if you visit, for example, this next web page, you can download these reports. So thank you for your attention. And okay.
Great. Thank you, Juha.
Thank you.
What kind of questions do we have from the room? And just also for those participating via internet, I'll just remind you the Slido that you can use, sli.do, and the password is geo22. So you can ask your questions, comments, etc.
Was it so clear?
Actually, I have a
I
question.
Don't think so.
So I have some experience working with, for example, SINTEF in Norway.
SINTEF. That's the coordinator.
So does GTK also do the coordinations of these projects as well, or is there another coordinator? Does somebody else do that work?
No, we actually do it by ourselves. And there are certain people like me who are specialized.
Who are specialized in
yeah, yeah.
That's pretty much
but
what they
do. I would like to have more people to do that work, or otherwise, because I will retire in maybe seven years.
No.
Okay. All right. Any other questions? Alan, just a moment. Here comes the microphone.
Just in terms of like, scientists, sometimes they have difficulties to start to build up all this network. You show that GTK have a really beautiful network all across Europe. How do you start this? Just thinking about the situation here in Estonia now. Do GTK put some seeding funding there for the for the researchers that they could start to use a little bit of a grant to build up this network? And how do the people here in Estonia can start to grow that network?
Actually, at GTK, we don't have special funds for that. But of course, when we are building up the consortium, there is certain, how do you say, hanken number, project number that I put it, like building up the new EU proposals. But there was, for example, Next and Mireu, they were actually funded from European, this ESIF, funds EAKR, this, what is European Structural Funds. There was a certain project that the intention was to build up the networks and start to cooperate with people, other organizations in Europe and elsewhere. And there was a lot of money only for that purpose, that you could travel to, for example, to Canada, the PDAC conference and things like that. And that was really good for Mireo and Next. But GTK, we don't have that kind of, I hope we, well, Kimmo's not yet, so we cannot ask from Kimmo.
All right. Any other last questions? In that case, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.